JPA and Hibernate require you to write lots of strings. You use them to create ad-hoc and named queries with Jpql, to define native SQL queries, and to specify the fetching behavior in an entity graph. Until Java 13, the lack of multiline strings in Java made all of these tasks either annoying to implement or the code hard to read. You either had to concatenate multiple strings or put everything into a long single line string. That changed drastically with the introduction of Java text blocks. You can finally define strings that span over multiple lines by using three quotation marks. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen and I solve Java persistence problems for a living. In this video, I will show you how to use Java text blocks with Hibernate and JPA. But before we begin, if you are new here, please subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also, don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. By doing so, you are helping me to reach more people with it. As you can see here, a multiline string makes the SQL statement much easier to read. And because this is a standard Java feature, you can use it everywhere you use a string. But it's especially useful if the string is long and complex enough that you want to add line breaks. Let's take a look at a few examples in the IDE. JPA's query language JPQL and the Hibernate-specific extension HQL enable you to write queries based on your entity model. The syntax is very similar to SQL, and I explained it in great detail in my guide to JPQL, and you will get the link to it in the description. And here. JPQL and HQL are not as powerful as SQL. Nonetheless, you can create pretty complex queries that are hard to read in a single line. The following query returns book author review count objects that might be used in a list view in the UI. The query selects the name of the author by joining first name and last name, the title of the book, and counts the number of reviews of each book. This query isn't easy to read if you write it as a simple single line string. Adding a few line breaks and handling it as a multiline string makes that much easier. And the same is true if you create the same query as a named query. You can then use the text block within the named query annotation. JPA was intentionally designed as a leaky abstraction that enables you to access the underlying JDBC layer. You can use it to write and execute native SQL queries that your persistence provider doesn't analyze. Using this approach, you can use all query features supported by your database. I used that in the following SQL statement to select the title of all blog posts and books, the type of publication, and the name of the author. As you can see, books and blog posts are stored in two separate tables. I query both tables to get the title together with the type of publication and use a union clause to merge the results into one result set. That's something you can't do with JPQL, but you can easily do it using a native SQL statement. And if you combine your native SQL query with an SQL result set mapping, you can get your query result as entity objects, DTO objects, or scalar values. I referenced such a mapping in the previous code snippet to map each record in the result set to a publication author object. The required mapping definition is relatively simple. You only need to use a constructor result annotation, provide the class you want to instantiate as the target class, and define an array of column result annotations to specify the constructor parameters. You can not only use Java text blocks to define your queries. In version 5.4, Hibernate introduced an API to pass a string into an entity graph. These strings describe a hierarchical structure and their readability benefits from multiline strings. An entity graph tells Hibernate which associations it shall initialize when fetching the result of a query. This is an important performance tuning tool that you need to know when working with Hibernate. The string used in the following example gets passed into an entity graph that tells Hibernate to fetch the book and blog post associations defined on the author entity. For the book association, it will also fetch the associated publisher and the editor who worked on the book. If you are using such an entity graph, Java's text block feature can improve the readability of your code. But you also need to double-check your query and analyze if fetching that many associations makes your query too complex. Depending on the number of elements in each association, it might be better to split this query into multiple ones. Java's text blocks might look like a small feature, but they can improve the readability of your code a lot. Because it's a standard Java feature, you can use it everywhere in your code, but not all places will benefit the same. Text blocks are especially useful if the created string naturally contains line breaks or gets easier to read if you split it over multiple lines. With JPA and Hibernate, you create a lot of strings that belong in the second category. Especially queries get often long and complex. Spreading them over multiple lines allows you to structure them visually and to improve their readability. I'm sure that it won't take long until everyone uses Java text blocks to write their queries. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content like a cheat sheet for this video and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!